Hello, so good to meet you at this global motivational meeting. We reading World Scripture book to inspire and empower with positive vibe for the day. This book helped billions of people, families, communities, countries, and the whole world, and will help you to just read these holy quotes and practice them. Further, let's read. Today's topic is cultivating the good. Goodness requires effort, since evil infests our world and infects our minds and bodies. We mostly find it difficult to do the right thing. Hence, to become a genuinely good person requires sustained effort at self-cultivation. Aristotle writes that cultivating good character is like learning an art or a skill. If a person makes a continual effort to practice good deeds over a long period, he will form good habits. Good habits cultivated over many years lead to the formation of a good character. The human spirit is like a field that must be sowed, cultivated, and weeded every day. It is to bear a good crop. If people do not attend to goodness but tolerate small faults, over time they will develop bad habits that becomes progressively more ingrained. Does good begets good, while evil begets evil. Father Moon reminds us that because the propensity for evil is highly developed in fallen people, we must be actively engaged in efforts to do good, as even simple neglect that can lead to our downfall. Cultivating the good through a lifetime of practice. Not to do any evil, to cultivate good, to purify one's mind. This is the teaching of the Buddha. The virtues we acquire by first having actually practiced them, just as we do the arts. We learn an art or craft by doing the things that we shall have to do when we have learned it. For instance, men became builders by building houses, harpers by painting on the harp. Similarly, we became just by doing just acts, temperate by doing temperate acts, brave by doing brave acts. Carefully upon the proper norm of conduct and imitate them day and night, so that there will be not be a moment neglect or cessation. After a time, we became familiar with them, and then we no longer need to imitate them, but can make our own standard. Gain the superior man, seeing what is good, imitates it. Seeing what is bad, he corrects in himself. Whatever you would make habitual, practice it. And if you would not make a thing habitual, do not practice it, but habituate yourself to something else. Engage in Torah and charity, even with an ulterior motive, for the habit of right doing will lead also to right motivation. By degrees, little by little, from time to time, a wise person should remove his own impurities, as a smith removed the dross from silver. By sustained effort, earnest discipline, and self-control left, the wise man make for himself an island which no flood can overcome. Study Torah leads to precision to zeal, zeal to cleanliness, cleanliness to restraint, restraint to purity, purity to holiness, holiness to meekness, meekness to fear no sin, fear of sin to saintless, saintless to the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit to the life eternal. This Atman represents and pure whom sinless disciples belong, residing with the body, is attained by until the practice of truthfulness, austerity, right knowledge, and continence. Make every effort to supplement your faith with virtue, and virtue with knowledge, and knowledge with the self-control, and self-control with steadfast, and steadfast with goodness, and goodness with brotherly affection, and brotherly affection with love. For if these things are yours and abound, they keep you from being ineffective or unfruitful in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Further, let's read quotes from the second coming Messiah, Father, Son, and Moon. Good and evil are not decided in the future, but in the present moment, every day. Wherever you are, good or evil, it is not determined by your thoughts. It is determined by your life. Just knowing in your head that what is good does not put you in any relationship with the real world. You cannot just pick up a difficult textbook and study it unless you first know how to read. You need to practice reading and train over a long period to become a good reader. You cannot be conscious of music, just be listening to a few pieces. You need to train over many years to understand that music deeply and in every aspect. You cannot just stand at the podium and instantly be a great speaker. It is required training. It is the same with our thinking, attitude, and behavior. We have to spend time training our minds and bodies. We can view meditation and prayer as a way of training the mind. Well-known violinists know the character of their own violin, having played it countless times, cleaning and caring for it for so long. They know how to make the best sound out of their instrument and can play in total harmony with it. Therefore, they make the most beautiful and even mysterious sounds. Just as a violinist makes special efforts to care for his instrument, you should make special efforts through prayer to cultivate your spirit. Wherever you go, you should raise your spiritual antenna and not be negligent even for a moment. How can we, who are fallen beings, return to God for goodness? First, we have to cultivate our conscience. Does we being to take after the goodness of our original self? Next, we have to act according to God's word. Does we reflect the goodness of God and the value of his word? After we have done things, we will become people who realize goodness and appreciate the value of God's goodness. God can then rejoice finding in us his ideal of goodness for which he created us, created all things and humankind. The spring grows through, spirit grows through give and take action between two types of nourishment, life elements of yang type and came from God, and vitality elements of yin type that came from the physical self. The spirit self also returned an element that to the physical self, which we call the leading spirit element. And truth illuminates the innermost desire of the spirit mind. A person must first comprehend his spirit mind deepest desire through the truth, and then put this knowledge into action to fulfill his responsibility. Only then do the leading spirit elements and vitality elements reciprocate with him, establishing him to progress toward goodness. The living spirit elements and the vitality elements have the relationship of the internal nature and external form, because all people have living spirit elements ever active within themselves. Even an evil person, original mind inclines toward goodness. However, unless he actually leads life of goodness, this living spirit elements cannot engage in proper give and take with the vitality elements, nor can they be infused into his physical self to make it wholesome. You can attain heaven only if you have unity within yourself. Therefore, do not be arrogant. Be humble, be a sacrifice. That is why we are taught to discipline the body through the path of religion. Although you dislike it, you should do fasting and make sacrifice for more than 3 years. So powerful quote. If you have difficulties today, please watch one more time this video. Share this video as we are on this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Contact me for consultation, cooperation, and become a member of this Heavenly Parents Holy Community. And see you tomorrow with more powerful quotes. All the best, yours, Coach.